मैं डॉक्टर डब्ल्यू बी गुंडले फ्रॉम कमला नेहरू महाविद्यालय नागपुर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द आयन एक्सचेंज क्रोमेटोग्राफी टेक्निक। इन दिस टेक्निक देयर इज अ एक्सचेंज ऑफ आयन्स इन बिटवीन सॉलिड स्टेट एंड द लिक्विड स्टेट टेक प्लेस, बट देयर इज नो एनी चेंज ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द कंपोनेंट ऑफ द आयन्स। एंड हियर वी आर गोइंग टू सी व्हाट यू मीन बाय आयन एक्सचेंज टेक्निक, आफ्टर दैट द प्रिंसिपल, एंड देन आयन एक्सचेंज टू टाइप्स ऑफ आयन एक्सचेंजर्स, cation exchanger, anion exchanger, and after that the ion exchange equilibria and the factor affecting the ion exchange equilibria, and lastly the applications of this ion exchange technique. So today is the we are talking about the ion exchange technique, and in this technique we can define this ion exchange technique that ion exchange may be defined as reversible exchange of like ions between the solid phase and the liquid phase, in which there is no permanent change in the structure, and this technique is sometimes called ion exchange chromatography. So in this ion exchange chromatography, and an ion exchange material is composed of charge groups that are fixed and ion of opposite sign that are able to move. The ions that are able to move are called mobile ions. The mobile ions can be exchanged for ion in the solution, provided that electrical neutrality is maintained. And it is observed that ion exchange material is packed in the column and used for the separation of ionic species in the similar manner like column adsorption chromatography. And that is why this method is also sometimes known as ion exchange chromatography. And many substances are there, both neutral, artificial, and have ion exchanging properties. But for analytical work, only the synthetic organic ion exchangers, that is called resins, are more interested. And the resins may exchange cation or anion, and hence they are also there are two types of ion exchangers. One is a cation and second is anion exchanger. Now widely used cation exchanger resins are there, and that obtained by the copolymerization of styrene and small proportions of divinyl benzene, and also followed by sulfonation, and it can be represented as shown in the next slide. That here is the group shown, and the polymer network along with the function group is represented as R. R is the resin, and ion exchange can be written as here. This is the polymeric chain and containing sulfonic acid group, and here this is the resin, R for resin. H plus is there. Sometimes it is in a hydrated form. So different types of structures are containing positive ions, negative ions, RH plus, RNA plus, R, ROH minus, RCl minus. And these ion exchange ions are reversible. The process of ion exchange depends upon the extent of the to which the ions are exchanged. So there is an exchange of ion. So positive ion is replaced by other positive ion, and negative ion replaced by. So there is exchange of negative ion or positive ion from the resin. So in the next slide now we are going to see what is the principle of this ion exchange technique. So basic principle of this ion exchange technique is that in ion exchange technique, this technique is carried out using special material. That material is known as ion exchange resin. These resins are insoluble organic polymer into which charge groups are introduced. The base polymer is generally styrene divinyl benzene copolymer. The resin contains some ionic sites where exchange of ion can take place. These sites sometimes are known as maybe cations or anion. When ions in the solution come in contact with these ions, they displace these ions from their position, and the solution coming out of the column contains ion of the resin. After complete separation of the ion on the resin, one of the ion is eluted out with the help of suitable solvent. In this way, other ions remain intact on the resin, and in the similar manner, changing the solvent one by one, each ion in the mixture can be eluted selectively. And after elution of the component or the ions, then the eluted, or we can say that eluted or collected from the column, is then analyzed quantitatively with the help of different methods such as spectrophotometric, polarographic, conductivity, volumetric, etc., which give the concentration of the ionic species. So this is the basic principle. We have to first take the column and then regions, and then we have to do the ion exchange. So this is the basic principle, and one by one the component can be separated from that column by using suitable solvent. So now, types of ion exchangers. As we know, there are two types of ion exchangers, and these two types are cation exchanger and anion exchanger. And what is now cation exchanger, which contain positive charge, and cation exchangers should have replaceable positive ion. So that resin should contain the replaceable positive ion. It is a high molecular weight cross-linked polymer having sulfonic acid group or carboxylic acid group or phenolic acid groups as the main group, and equivalent number of cations are attached to them. These cations are active ions and can be exchanged with the cation in the solution. They are used in a hydrogen ion form or H plus or sodium ion forms. So it is shown here both the forms in this slide. In hydrogen form, the cation exchange shows following. This is the how the ion exchange take place. So this is the part of resin which contains replaceable H plus ion, and this is the sodium ion in the solution. So now here H plus ion gets separated, and now there is an exchange of H plus ion sodium ion. In sodium form, the cation exchange show following type of ion exchange equilibrium. So this is the ion exchange equilibrium. Resin contains sodium plus ion, and here is a calcium ion. So now this sodium ion gets replaced, and this resin with calcium is there. And so in this way, there is an exchange of ions can take place. So these are the exchange of ion taking shown here, both in a hydrogen form and the sodium form, sodium ion forms. So this is cation exchanger, how the exchange of ions take place. And next is the ion exchanger. And in case of ion exchanger, shown here in the slide, that this anion exchanger should have replaceable negative ion. And anion exchangers are polymers having amine or quaternary ammonium groups as the internal part of the resin, and equivalent number of anion such as chloride ion, sulfate ion, hydroxide ion, etc. We can say that are attached to them. These anions can be exchanged with the anions of the solution. The anion exchange equilibrium can also be represented as shown in this slide. So here is a this is the resin, alpha resin, and this is the chloride. So this chloride can get separate, and now in place of that OH minus is there. So in this way there is an exchange of ions. So anion exchanges are those. There should be a exchange of negative ion can take place between the resin and the solution. So another example is also there. Another exchange with the tertiary amine group also strong in anion exchanger, whereas in primary and secondary amino group anion exchange take place very slow or weakly. So these are the two types of cation and anion exchangers. And now after this, we are going to see what is meant by ion exchange capacity. As we know, ion exchange capacity can be defined as the total number of ion active grouping per unit weight of the material. Again, I am repeating, the total ion exchange capacity of the resin can be defined as the total number of ion active grouping per unit weight of the material. So how many active groups are there, and total number of these active ion group present per unit weight of the material, that capacity, that number is known as the capacity, or we can say that it is known as ion exchange capacity. This simply we can say that ion exchange capacity increases with the increase in the ion active groups in the region. Naturally it is increases, okay, but the total ion exchange capacity is expressed as milliequivalent per gram of the exchanger. The capacity of cation exchange resin is evaluated by measuring the number of milligram equivalent of sodium ion taken up by the 1 gram of dry resin in hydrogen form. And now the formula to calculate the ion exchange capacity is shown in the slide here. So ion exchange capacity is equals to V into N upon W. So what is V? Is the volume of alkali solution huge. N is the normality of that alkali solution, and W is the weight of that resin. So by putting all these values, the capacity of ion exchange capacity can be of that resin can be determined. So how many active ion active groups are present in the resin, that capacity is known as the ion exchange capacity. So this is different in different resin, and the regions are also cations and cation exchange resin, and an ethylene resin. So depending upon the nature, groups are present in the resin, they have different capacity of ion exchange. And next slide, here we are going to see. So some cations are strong cation exchanger, some are weak cation exchanger, and also in case of anion, also strong and weak anion exchangers are there. So here example is shown that the ion exchange reaction with strong and weak ion exchangers are shown here in this slide. Here and in this slide, see here, this is the resin part, this is the strong cation exchanger. So this is the SO3 group from the sulfuric acid, it is a strong acid, therefore this is the alpha resin and containing this strong group, and this is the in this case there is a, this is SO3H sulfuric acid group, and H plus can replace and therefore can exchange, and this is called labile, this active group, active ion. And this is the M plus, another cation. So M plus is coming here and H plus is replaced. So there is a ion exchange take place between M plus and H plus. Similarly, in case of weak COOH, so this is carboxylic acid group, it is a weak cation exchanger. And therefore, H and this again metal can change, show the change, exchange is taking place, and now H plus is released. And in case of anion, also similarly, this is the group that is called, this is the resin, alpha resin, and this is group containing the Cl minus, this is the labile ion, this Cl minus get replaced, and here is coming OH minus ion. So ion, Cl minus ion release in the weak, now here this resin and another this is the weak resin, labile ion is Cl minus again, and OH minus coming there, and ion Cl minus. So in this way, there are strong cation, weak cation, strong anion, weak anion, and there is an exchange of positive ion or negative ion between the solution and the resin. And next, what are the factors that affecting the ion exchange equilibrium? So four different factors are there. First factor is the charge on the ion, and in case of this charge of the ion, see now here in the slide it is shown, and this slide shows that first part is the charge on the cation or the ion, and it is observed that at low concentration of the solution, the extent of exchange increases with the increase in the charge of ion. That is, we can say that extent of exchange follow the order shown here. Sodium ion is less than calcium ion, then Na3 plus ion, then thorium 4 plus ion. So that order is show the affinity. So we can say that there is a stronger is the affinity of the ion for the resin. So greater the charge, stronger is the affinity. So here is the charge is 4 plus, here is 3 plus, 2 plus, 1 plus. So 1 plus is there, therefore they are less. 2 plus is greater. So greater the charge, greater the affinity, or stronger is the affinity of ion for the resin to exchange and ion exchange. Okay, then second part is the size of hydrated ion. And in case of size of hydrated ion, also we can say that where the charge on the ion is same, the extent of exchange decreases with increase of size of the hydrated ion. So again I am repeating, when the charge on the ion is same, but the extent of exchange decreases with the increase of in the size of hydrated ion. And we can say that singly charged cation, the extent exchange follow the order that is shown here in the example. We can say that similarly, the condition that here extent of exchange increases with the decrease in the size of the hydrated ion. So size decreases. So here now, here charges are same on all the ions, plus 1, plus 1, plus 1. But the size increases. Ni plus 1 have less than sodium ion, then potassium ion, because lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium are the first group, and where it is size increases from lithium to here, up to rubidium, like that. Okay, so the charge are same, but the size decreases, and therefore it is observed that extent of exchange increases with the decrease in the size. If the size decreases, exchange, so in case of this example, lithium have greater exchanging capacity or exchange ability. Okay, so therefore we say that in case of this, lithium is the largest and exchange ability, the exchangeability is minimum, and in this case size of hydrated ion of lithium is largest, and therefore they have less exchangeability is minimum in case of lithium. Okay, so this is the order. Also, another example is there in case of 2 plus ion. In case of negative ion also, minus minus 1, minus 1. So, here the extent of action increases with the decrease in the size. So, this is the example of size of hydrated ion. And third one is the ability of ion to form complexes. In case of also, some ions also form some complexes, and the tendency of ion, that is unhydrated ion, to form the complexes increases as the tendency get exchange decreases. So this is third one. This is not so more important. But now here, fourth one is now here, nature of regime. And in case of nature of regime, we can say that absorption of ion depends upon the nature of function group in the regime. It also depends upon the degree of cross-linking. As the degree of cross-linking in the regime increases, the region become more selective towards the ion, and therefore we can say that the good region should have some criteria or certain properties, and these properties are shown in the slide, that the good the good region. So region should have some conditions. That means it must be a sufficiently cross linked, should have negligible solubility, it should be a sufficiently hydrophilic to permit the diffusion of ion at finite rate. Another condition is that it should contain sufficient number of exchangeable groups. And last one is that swollen region should have higher density than the water. Some of the examples also we are going to see here in the next slide. What are the commonly used ion exchange regions are there. And here this table shows the trade name and types, and after that the framework of material and the function group present in that region. So these are the some ambrolite, duolite, trade name is given, duex 50. So these are some important regions. We show the functional group. So commonly used ion exchange regions are shown here. So depending upon the function group, there is an exchange of ion take place between the region and the solution. And lastly, the last part is the application of ion exchange. So first application is the deionization of water, and in case of this deionization of water is carried out by passing the natural water through the two columns. First column is of acidic cation exchanger in hydrogen form. This column replaces all cation with H plus ion. In second column, the basic anion exchanger in hydroxide form we have to take. This column replaces all the anion with OH minus, and therefore these H plus and OH minus ion combine to form the pure water. So it is useful for the deionization of water. And second application is the separation of sodium ion and the potassium ion. And this is also possible with the help of ion exchange. So separation of sodium and potassium ion can be carried out by passing their solution through the cation exchanger in acidic form, and elution is carried out using the hydrochloric acid solution. Sodium, being less firmly held, move down the column more rapidly, while potassium elute out afterward. From this solution, solvent is evaporated and the chloride salt are redissolved in water, and then Mohs titration with AgNO3 is used for the analysis. And third one is the separation of transition metal ion like copper ion, nickel ion or cobalt 2 plus ion. So this transition metal ion can also be separated by using ion exchange method. So in this case, the separation can be achieved by using the strong base anion exchange regime. Solution of the ion is prepared in HCl solution, in which cobalt 2 plus form a chloro complex, that is CoCl4 2 minus, but nickel does not. This complex is retained by the regime, while nickel 2 plus passes unaffected. After complete elution of nickel, cobalt is eluted using 3 molar HCl, and therefore separated solution can be analyzed colorimetrically, and nickel is estimated by using a DMG, while cobalt is estimated by using 1 nitroso 2 naphthol. So in this way, this is the third application. And fourth is the separation of chloride and the bromide. This is the negative ions. And in case of chloride and negative ion, bromide ion separation, in this case the anion exchange column is converted into nitrate form by passing concentrated sodium nitrate solution. Concentrated solution of mixture of chloride and the bromide is added from the top of the column. After that, halide ion exchange with the nitrate ion in the resin forming band at the top of the column. These ions are eluted by adding sodium nitrate solution from the top, and chloride ion are eluted first and then bromide ion come out. The fractions are titrated with the standard silver nitrate solution using adsorption indicator. So it is possible to calculate the concentration of chloride and bromide ion in the mixture. And next example is the separation of lanthanide. So separation of lanthanide is also possible by using a ion exchange technique, and lanthanide in this lanthanide series elements occur in the nature in various ore. These ores contain almost all lanthanide together. Separation of these lanthanide is difficult task as they resemble in most of their properties. They have almost similar size and all of them exist in a +3 oxidation state. They have equal charge density, and therefore ion exchange technique is the most rapid an effective method for the separation and purification of lanthanide. Okay, and after that, the number 6 is the separation of actinide. So separation of actinide is also possible by ion exchange technique, and this technique is a unique play the unique role in the separation of actinide. In actinide series also, the elution occur in the reverse order of the atomic number due to actinide contraction, and this shows that only the it is the only way for identifying this element. And lastly is the separation of amino acid. So amino acid, as we know, that ion exchange method has been used to separate the complex mixture of 18 amino acid obtained by the acid hydrolysis of protein. So by using ion exchange also, it is possible to separate the amino acid. So these are the some important applications of ion exchange regimes. And so today we stop here, and we have seen that there are two types of ion exchanger, cation exchanger and anion exchanger. Also we have seen ion exchange equilibria, ion exchange capacity of the regimes. So regimes are two types, cation exchange regime and anion exchange regime. And what is the principle of ion exchange regime? How, what are the factors which are affecting the ion exchange equilibria? And we have seen the important applications of this ion exchange technique, that is the deionization of water, removal of positive and negative ions, removal of separation of bromide and chloride, separation of lanthanide, separation of actinide, separation of amino acids, and so many applications are there. So this technique is very important technique for the separation of transition metal ions or lanthanide or actinide or amino acids.